Male pattern baldness or androgenic alopecia is hair loss in men that leads to the thinning and eventual loss of the hair. In this video, I'm going to share with you 7 of my top tips to help stop hair loss and help you regrow your hair. So let's begin with tip number 1. First of all, I fully understand how emotional it can be when you're losing your hair, okay? But in tip number 1, what I want to say to you is don't delay treatment, okay? Act quickly, because the simple fact is this: when your hair follicles start to shrink or die, it is very difficult to revive them. So if you're starting to see hair loss, act quickly so that we can get the best outcome, we can get the best hair growth, we can reduce the hair loss. And now we're going to talk about some treatment. So let's dive straight into tip number 2. Let's begin with treatments. We're going to start off with minoxidil. It's an over-the-counter topical solution that you spray onto your scalp. It is a very good treatment for hair regrowth, okay? Studies have shown that it helps extend your growth phase of the hair cycle. It also reduces hair shedding and it thickens the finer hairs on your scalp, okay? One thing you need to bear in mind though, you have to be patient with this treatment. It can take up to 6 months to start showing effect. So in tip number 3, the next treatment I want to discuss is only for men and it's called Finasteride. It comes as a pill form. It also comes as a topical form that you can spray on. It also pairs really well with minoxidil that we've just spoke about. The way it works is it blocks something called 5-alpha reductase, which basically lowers your DHT level. Now, if you're wondering to yourself, what is DHT? It's basically a byproduct of testosterone. It basically binds to your hair follicle receptors and it basically shortens the growth phase. So that means that eventually with time, you get more hair thinning and hair loss. So that's the basics of androgenic alopecia, otherwise known as male pattern baldness. And if you have a genetic predisposition to DHT sensitivity, then that's basically why it's happening. So the treatments are all about reducing DHT so it doesn't cause that effect. So that's just a bit of information about how these treatments work. Straight on to tip number 4, look, losing your hair can be emotional, okay? It's very hard for a lot of people. I completely understand it. No one likes going to the shower, washing your hair, and you're seeing a load of hair on your fingers or it's clogging up the shower, okay? But one thing you need to bear in mind is you need to continue your normal hair washing routine, brushing your hair, washing your hair, cleaning your scalp, just so we can maintain a healthy scalp. A healthy scalp is going to be crucial for hair growth, okay? So if you all of a sudden stop doing it and stop brushing your hair, stop washing your hair because you're worried about the hair falling out, look, I'm going to be really honest with you. The hair cycle, if it's going to fall, that is the destiny of that hair. You cannot change it, okay? But you still need to be washing your hair, looking after your hair, looking after your scalp health, because if you don't do that, it's just going to make things worse, I promise you. Tip number 5, be mindful of the ingredients in your shampoo and conditioners. Certain ingredients that I would really avoid, such as isopropyl alcohol, parabens, sulfates, and triclosan, okay? Ketoconazole is a good shampoo as well to use. There are certain studies that it has some effect on DHT and how it affects your hair follicles, but it also maintains a healthy scalp, which is all good for hair growth and stopping hair loss. Moving straight on to tip number 6, you may have seen these helmets before. This is known as low-level laser therapy, okay? The way it works is something called photobiomodulation. Basically, these little lasers here, the light emitted from them is absorbed by your hair follicles. This basically means that we get more growth factors, we get more blood flow and revitalization of your hair, okay? Low level laser therapy has been shown to increase density and thickness of your hair, and it's a great addition to the other treatments that we spoke about. It's completely safe to add it in alongside those treatments. In terms of devices, there are loads of them out there. I would recommend picking one that's FDA approved. That's really important. I don't like the handheld ones, okay? I just find them awkward and really difficult to use, but these helmet ones are the go-to, okay? Very easy to use, and you can just do your normal daily activities whilst it's doing its work. And this leads me on ever so nicely to discuss the FDA approved CURRENTBODY LED hair growth helmet. The unique helmet shape gives full coverage of the scalp. It also has 120 red 640 nanometer LED bulb diodes. And the best thing, it's completely hands-free. Just pop it on your head. It takes 10 minutes for you to get that photobiomodulation we discussed earlier whilst you're doing your normal daily activities. Now, the CURRENTBODY team are very good friends of the channel. I personally love using their products. And don't forget to use my discount code in the description below to save loads off any product that you get. Best of all, with this product, for example, the helmet, you've got a 120-day money-back guarantee if you're not fully satisfied, okay? So bear that in mind as well. Current Body, thank you for being our trusted sponsor. Straight into tip number 7, stay positive and be proactive, okay? You've got this, but also remember, please do speak to your medical provider. Any hair loss that isn't normal for you, speak to your medical provider so they can examine you, they can do the necessary tests, make sure it's nothing else that's contributing to it. That is really important. Like always, I hope all these tips are helpful and sending awesome vibes.